Here we go now. Tom Hamilton, he, of course, is in Goodyear, Arizona. You don't think Tom's going to hang out in Wisconsin, do you, with the nice warm weather? As he says hello on the Indians. Thomas, welcome. We got a lot to do today. Let's start with Lindor. Is this a PR move by Lindor so he doesn't get booed, or does he actually want to stay with the Indians long term?
Well, you know what, Chris? These guys aren't dumb. I think Frankie does love Cleveland. I really do. Frankie, I think he likes the lower profile, and, you know, it's been a good fit for him. And let's face it, ever since he's been an Indian, the Indians have either been in the playoffs or, like last year, you win 93 games, so you're a playoff-caliber team, and you just miss out. So he loves to win. I think he loves the lower profile that the city of Cleveland gives him. But at the end of the day, Chris, you know, Frankie Lindor is going to become a free agent, and he's going to put himself out there to the highest bidder. He has earned that right. I mean, I think a lot of GMs would tell you if they were starting a team today, the guy they would pick to start that team is Frankie Lindor. So when he becomes a free agent, he's going to be the brightest bauble on the market that winter. And so I think Frankie loves Cleveland, but at the end of the day, there's no way, unless all of a sudden Frankie and his agent decide it's more important to stay in Cleveland than get the highest dollar, that he'll stay in Cleveland.
All right, well, that's pretty honest, Tom. Well done. So, I mean, that's going to put the Indians in a tough spot, because if he tells everybody for 2 years, I love it here, let me stay here, and they still let him go, somebody's going to take the hit for that in that town. We'll have to wait and see. Now, how about the starting pitchers? You know, obviously, no Kluber. Carrasco, obviously, issues here. Clevinger had surgery. You know, Bieber, they need this pitching. This is the key to their team. You know, they have good pitching. Is it healthy? What can you tell me about that right now?
Well, I think Clevinger and Carrasco will be short-term as far as injuries. They're both, you know, without crutches right now. Carrasco was the hip flexor. I think it was more scary than it was serious. I think he thought he seriously hurt himself. He did not. And so, you know, they're going to slow play Carlos Carrasco based on everything that he went through last year with his battle and leukemia. Mike Clevinger showed us last year how quick a healer he is. But you know what, Chris? Even though it's microscopic, even though it's minor knee surgery, it's minor if it's not your knee.
That's a good point.
More major when it's a guy like Mike Clevinger who's got a violent delivery. He does a lot of torquing off that front side, which is the knee that they repaired the left side. So, again, the Indians will be very cautious. Even though Mike Clevinger wants to go 150 miles an hour in the rehab, you got to pull back on him. He is too valuable for this ball club. And to your point, Chris, they can't afford serious injuries to guys like Clevinger, Carrasco, Bieber, Lindor, Ramirez. They don't have enough depth to overcome that, much like they did a year ago, even though they didn't make the playoffs.
I had a good year, as you said, 93 wins. Division will be a little tougher. How about everyday players, Tom? They never have enough outfielders. I know the kid last year came up and played really well. Ramirez needs to be good for 150 games instead of just, you know, a month or two. Do they have enough offense with the eight guys or not? Let me hear.
Well, I think another big key, obviously, is health to the guys you mentioned, Ramirez, Lindor, Carlos Santana, but also Franmil Reyes. You know, Chris, this is a guy that I don't know how many people realize he had 38 home runs last year in his first full year in the major leagues, and he had 21 of them with San Diego in a pitcher's park in a division that features pitcher's parks when you talk about Dodger Stadium and whatever the Giants Park is called anymore, plus San Diego. So, you know, Franmil Reyes has got a chance to become a superstar slugger in the middle of the Indians lineup. And with his personality, and he's a guy that could kind of take over a city because he's got that gregarious, outgoing personality. He's a big man with big power. The question is, Chris, can you play him in the outfield, or is he strictly a DH?
Yeah, and you wonder if he's got a little Dave Kingman in him, too. A lot of homers, but a lot of 210 batting averages. We'll have to wait and see on that. But you know, here's a good thing, Tommy. Your division, you're going to get 37 cracks or thereabouts at Detroit and Kansas City. That's a plus. You know, the White Sox on paper look much improved. Let's see. And the Twins are good, but, you know, they're not overpoweringly good. And you obviously have a big manager in Francona and a team, front office-wise, that will maneuver some if you're in a race. I mean, you should be pretty competitive in the American League Central. Whether you're playoff good, I'm not sure about. But I would be surprised if you're much less than 87, 88 wins. Don't you think so?
I would agree. Chris, they legitimately have a chance to play in October. And as we see every October, get to October, who knows who's going to get hot. I mean, what was Washington, five outs away from elimination in a wild card game last year? I mean, the Indians were a team nobody expected to get to the series in 16 with all their injuries. They legitimately can play in October. I think, Chris, as this sounds, I think weather could have a big impact on this club. Chris, they don't play in a warm weather city the first month of the year. They start the season in Cleveland. They play in Cleveland. They play in Detroit, Minnesota. Tampa Bay, of course, comes to Cleveland in the middle of April, because why wouldn't you have Tampa Bay come to Cleveland in the middle of April? Then they go and play Detroit, Boston, and New York. So you better hope you have good weather in the month of April. And you know the other thing, Chris? 10 out of your first 20 games are against the Detroit Tigers. You don't want to play a rebuilding team 10 out of 20 times to start the year, because that team still thinks they're really
good. They're in it. Yeah, they're a good point. They're in the flow a little bit. You know, and the weather's been great in the Northeast. We can play baseball today and watch April snow on April 30th. So there you go. We will keep in touch, Tommy. Sorry about your Packers. Maybe next time. Not a good performance against the 49ers. I'm sure the gin and tonic was thrown against the wall. But it's always a pleasure to talk to you. See you soon.
Bye,
I love you.